The worst time to have a heart attack is during a game of charades.
Grab a chair, I'm a swear, when this is down,
it's my podcast.
This guy's insane, rock your brain, it's just so Steve here I'm
Vault. Promised another Vieira Vault. Hey man, every week I got a new one like I promised, and man, the last episode I did alone and it's got a lot of positive feedback, and I'll be reading some of those positive feedbacks at the end of this episode. I got a lot to talk about as far as just one subject, why I will never support Zakk Wylde again unless something changes. But before I get into that, my friends, I want to tell you all about the Rockin' Pod Expo that's going on in Nashville. Now, the Rock and Metal Combat Podcast is taking donations, and there's a link below. And the way it works is we've been doing it this is the third time we've done it, and we've raised the most money. Our listeners are the most fanatic, so hopefully some of you listeners listen to this, because once again, we're taking donations for Rock and Pod Expo 3. It looks like our listeners are raising the most again this year, like last year, because they rule. But none of this goes into our pocket. All the money goes to the Rock and Pod Expo 3. Now, you know, it's for a good cause, because they just recently added Dave Ellison from Megadeth. I'm going to have a promo later where it's before Dave Ellison, so you'll hear who else is on the roster. So, this is the way we're working it. $40 if you want an episode. I'm talking about Rock and Metal Combat Podcast. There, I'm going to take donations for Vieira Vault, but I'll tell you about it after I tell you how the Rock and Metal Combat Podcast does it. It's $40 for an episode, $60 for an episode, and you guessed on it, which means you pick the episode. As far as the $40 too, you pick what album or review. $60, you pick what album or review, and you guessed on the episode. $100 for an episode that you review. You ask us to review something we hate, like Sammy Hagar. You know, we'll review something like that or just as bad. So there's a link below. So make sure when you donate, in the comment section, you write RMCP, Rock and Metal Combat Podcast. And then send your episode request to Ian Wadley or me. Now, if you want to be on the Vieira Vault, I'm going to charge $40. $40, you get to choose what subject we talk about. It could be a band, it could be movies, it could be something that I'm interested in. If you say something I'm not going to be interested in, then you're doing most of the talking. All I'm going to do is go, But $40. And you get to appear on the show with me. Make sure you got Skype and a microphone. And $40. $40. You donate to that link below. And you leave a comment that you paid for the Vieira Vault. And what you want to talk about on the Vieira Vault. And we'll get in touch, man. So, or ma'am. $40. Donate to the Vieira Vault section. If not, do the Rock and Metal Combat Podcast. Have us raise the most money again for the third year in a row. Now I'm going to play you a promo of the Rock and Pod Expo. Now, Dave Ellison from Megadeth has just been added, but he just been added like really recently. So what you're about to hear now doesn't mention Dave Ellison, but this is who else is on the roster. And there will be more. I heard some really cool names, but I can't talk about it yet because it's not confirmed. But here's a promo to the Rockin' Pod Expo 3.
Rockin' Pod is back. The annual celebration of rock returns to Nashville. This convention brings together the best rock stars, music podcasters, vinyl and memorabilia vendors, and rock fans from all corners of the globe. Special guests include Michael Sweet of Striper, Brian Forsyth of Kix, Jason Beeler of Saigon Kick, Erie Vaughn of Danzig and members of Exodus, Roxy Blue, Every Mother's Nightmare, Kick Tracy, and more. Music podcasts from all over North America will be recording on-site all weekend. special pre-party featuring the Rock and Roll Residency, The Talisman, 8 Ball, and Lipstick Generation on Friday night. Rock and Pod Expo on Saturday. Join us at the Nashville Airport Marriott August 9th and 10th for Rock and Pod. Podcast registration and tickets and VIP packages available now at rockandpod.com.
All right, there you go, man. I hope you all can make it. I'd like to hang out with all you at the Rock and Pod Expo in Nashville. All right, so what's the deal, huh? Why did I call this episode "I Will No Longer Support Zakk Wylde" or something like that? Well, let me start from the beginning. I love Zakk Wylde. I mean, the first time I saw him, No Rest for the Wicked tour in Tampa with Anthrax opening, which, by the way, that's where Anthrax shot the live footage of Antisocial in the parking lot and inside the Sundome in Tampa. And blew me away, man. What a guitar solo under his leg, over his neck, you know, above his head. Phenomenal. Phenomenal guitar player. One of my favorites. One of my favorites. And I have supported Zakk, everything he's done, every single thing, starting with Pride and Glory, and Book of Shadows, I would say, is my favorite album of the 90s. I think that album is a masterpiece, and the only way I would fucking throw money at that guy again, if he finally releases it on vinyl, then I'll have to, oh, fuck, maybe I'll fucking put a GoFundMe, so, you know, everybody put in a buck. So I don't have to waste another penny on this guy. Now, why? Why am I not supporting Zakk Wylde anymore? Well, and this is nothing recent, actually. This has been like maybe a year or two ago. I own everything Zakk Wylde. Like I was saying, you know, I bought all the Black Label. Some better than others. Not all Black Label albums are perfect. I'll admit that. But some are just amazing. First one, Stronger Than Death. I loved Stronger Than Death, and Mafia was cool, and I loved the black one. What's the black one with the logo? Whatever. The one that took him a long time. But, you know, the last couple ones, eh. But anyway, every time Zakk came to town, I would see him. I remember the Book of Shadows tour. He played a fucking restaurant in Fort Lauderdale. No shit, a restaurant. And it was one of those where he was with his friend on acoustic and had a little piano on stage. It was a phenomenal show in a restaurant. But I was glad to see that. I saw Pride and Glory at the Bayfront. I seen Black Label every single time they've been down here. Even when they opened for Judas Priest, even though I would have went to that anyway, duh. But, you know, I saw him open for Judas Priest. I was there. Headline Revolution, I was there. Zakk did an unplugged show in the Culture Room. I was there. Everything. That the guy, anytime that guy comes to South Florida, I'm there. You know, plus, you know, with Ozzy. And, you know, the Hendrix tribute. I went to that. He was there. I was there. Oh, also on the Motorboat. I saw him play in the Motorboat. He did two shows, acoustic. Awesome. I filmed it. But I've never given it out. I have uncirculated footage of Zakk Wylde. All right. This is what happened. All right, I'll get to it. He did the Zakk Sabbath thing where he goes up there and he does nothing but Black Sabbath songs. Black Sabbath's my favorite band in the world. So, of course, I go to that. And this is the first and only time I paid for a meet and greet. It was cheap. I forgot how much it was, but it was cheap. Like, I don't know, $40 maybe? I don't know. I don't remember. I know it wasn't that much. And I did the meet and greet. I met him, you know, I met him also on the boat, and I met him on the Book of Shadows restaurant show. The guy's nice. The guy's great. He's really cool to his fans. He's awesome. So what's my problem? All right. I have a friend who got there late, and she missed the picture part. She missed taking the picture. She got there during the autograph session. Sure. Then you go wait in line again as they set up a table, and you get your shit autographed. Well, she got there too late where, so I say, hey, don't worry. When we get up, you know, to get our shit signed, I'll tell Zakk about it and he'll get that picture with you because he's a cool dude. He'll do it. So we get up there and, you know, I hand Zakk my Zakk Sabbath vinyl and I say, Hey, Zakk, my friend here, you know, she got here late and she didn't get to take a picture with you. Right when I said that, his jack-off bodyguard, whoever this guy is, hey, we'll take care of that later. Like, already, I was like, whoa, okay, all right, fine, as long as she gets her picture, you know? Now, they took my picture with my camera, so, you know, I looked at it, and it's blurry as fuck. This is after this guy yelled at me that we'll take care of that picture thing. So they took a very blurry picture. I mean, it was so blurry you couldn't make it out, seriously. It was kind of like, you know, one of those, I don't know, like a streaky type picture. And so then when it was time for her to get an autograph, I mean, a picture with him, his dickhead security guard standing there, I say, showing him my camera. I go, look how bad this picture. Can I get another picture with him? He's like, we got to go. I mean, but yelling it in my face. I was like, wow, what a dick. So anyway, I never got my picture, even though I paid for the meet and greet. Whatever. I did get a group picture where all of us took a picture with Zakk. So I have that. So fast forward to the show. Now, remember, part of the VIP. So they leave us in there. So we get first dibs to, you know, it's a standing room only place. But I got all the way up front, center. And Zakk comes out and he starts fucking kicking ass. I think he opened with Children of the Grave, maybe. I'm not sure. He was just kicking ass. And I take out my camera. And I snap some pictures. I may have did a little video, but not for long. Because how close I am to the stage, the audio is just going to sound like... So, you know, maybe I took a little video. I don't know. I don't remember that. And then I proceeded to put my camera back inside my inside vest pocket. 2-3 songs later, and mind you, the whole coach room has their cell phones out, filming this guy, taking pictures, what have you. But me, I just took a couple pictures in the beginning and just was enjoying the fucking show. In the middle of like the fourth song, while my camera has been in my pocket this whole time, and there's cell phones surrounding me that are out taking pictures and stuff, this security fuck comes up to me. And by the way, this place was sold out. I mean, we're up there like sardines. And he grabs me. He grabs me by my vest saying, motherfucker, give me the camera. And at first I was like, what the fuck's going on? Because at first I didn't even understand he wanted my camera. I'm thinking, what the fuck's this guy's problem now? And then comes up to my, give me the fucking camera, you're getting kicked out of here. I was like, well, and then I just yelled back. I said, dude, if you let go of my arm, I'll give you my fucking camera. Because I was squashed up there. It was like sardines. I couldn't reach in, especially since this guy's like pulling my vest up. Complete prick. So I'm the type of guy that, boy, when I'm in the moment at a concert, nothing can distract me. Not even this cocksucker. So I give him my camera and proceeded to enjoy the show. Even forgot about him. Didn't think of my camera. Why should I? I wasn't going to take it out again. I'll get the camera back, you know, after the show. I played the culture room many times. I know everybody there. So I can get back there if I wanted to. For a camera, you know. So I enjoy the show, and it kicked ass. It was great. Zakk Wylde was awesome. And during the show, Zakk Wylde would go out in the crowd while everybody's surrounding him, taking pictures and filming him while he's super close doing a guitar solo. And who's standing next to him? The prick that took my camera. You know? I don't get it. I don't know why he singled me out. It still baffles me. But it didn't ruin the show for me. But what did ruin the night for me was after the show. I said, all right, I want my fucking camera back, you know, and I couldn't get it back. So talked to a couple bouncers. They said, wait here, Ralph, because they're my friends. These bouncers are my buddies. Wait here, we'll get your camera. And I was just in such a shitty mood because it took so long for them to get the camera, and I was getting really pissed. So I got the camera, and I left. I was going to buy, there was a kick-ass Zakk Sabbath shirt that had, it looked like the Volume 4 cover, but it's Zakk Wylde. And there was another one that was classic bootleg skull 666 type of Zach Savage shirt. I was gonna buy a lot of merch. Seriously. And I left. But when I left, I did not even think about, oh, let me go back and get the merch. I wasn't even thinking of the merch. I was in such a foul mood from this asshole that took forever to give me my camera back. And you know, noticing everybody took pictures and filmed with no problem. So anyway, so I go home. I'm in a foul mood. I didn't even say bye to my friends. I just fucking left. I was pissed. And I get home. And I said, well, you know, let me check out the pictures I took. But the guy took the memory card. He took the memory card from my camera on top of that. And that got me so fucking pissed off that I got online and I went to the Black Label Facebook, because I don't know how to get in touch with Zakk Wylde or management or whatever. I figured these people will. And I wrote a long explanation of everything I just said to you. And I got a reply from the person that runs the board saying, wow, that's messed up. He even said the guy's name. And I don't remember his name. And I don't care to remember his name. Shithead. I think that was his name. And so he said he was going to send what I just wrote to Barbara, which is Zakk Wylde's wife, I think, maybe manager, I'm not sure, you know, but he was going to send her the message. Whether he did or not, I don't know, because I never followed up on that guy. But, you know, I just said, I didn't want anything. I'm just, like, really fucking pissed off about this guy that's, you know, being security for Zakk, why he was such a dick that night. To me, out of everybody, singled me out. And I'm a guy that paid for VIP, okay, on top of this shit. And mind you, he yelled at me during the VIP. It makes me wonder why the fuck Zakk... And Zach's right there when he's yelling. But, you know, I didn't look at Zakk and see his reaction or if he even, like, looked. I don't know what happened there. I was just in shock. This guy fucking talked to me like this. I actually did... snap back. Don't get me wrong. I went, okay, all right, relax. I said that to him when he was like yelling at me about, we got to go. Like, all right. I get no picture. All right, fuck you. So, I've been this way since this day happened. I've not bought anything Zakk Wylde ever. I don't think I ever will again. Now, unless this guy gets fired and I know about it. Honestly, I don't even remember what the prick looks like. But hopefully you're hearing this, you know? Thanks, dude. Thanks. You're a fucking prick. You took my fucking... I paid for VIP. You fucking yelled at me. And then on top of that, you single me out. And you take my little thing. And by the way, it was at the Culture Room in Fort Lauderdale. I'm sure you remember me. Or do you do this at every show? Do you do this just so you can get memory cards? I don't know. I don't care. Shove that memory card up your ass. And don't worry. You'll never see me because I'm never going to anything Zakk Wylde's going to be, you know. He did come back after that for Hendrix thing. I didn't go. The Ozzy show that got canceled, Farewell, I wasn't going. I'm just not going. I love Ozzy, but no, I'm not going to do it. Nothing that comes out of my pocket is going into Zach's pocket so he can pay that prick. So that's why I no longer will support Zakk Wylde. If he releases Book of Shadows on vinyl, I'll start a Kickstarter. So all you can pitch in a buck. I need about, what, 15 of you. So there you go. That's it. That's why I'll never support Zakk Wylde ever again. So again, guys, like I said in the beginning of the show, there's a link below if you want to donate. I already told you how it is in the beginning, and you can donate to either the Rock and Metal Combat Podcast, or if you want to do a show with me, you pick the subject, something that I'd be into, though, like a band or whatever, you know, or a movie I love. If you know me, or, you know, just ask me questions of what you would want, $40, and you can be on a whole show, and we'll talk as long as we fucking want. So, before I go into the killer comments you guys left me last week, Let's go into the vault. All right, this week in the vault, I'm going to play you something that's very influential to Zakk Wylde. I've heard this person name-checked a lot by Zakk Wylde. Big influence, and boy, do I... One of my favorite guitar players, Frank Marino. Now, this ain't Frank Marino Mahogany Rush. This is off of, correct me if I'm wrong, maybe his first solo album, which is doesn't have Mahogany Rush on it, I think. And it does have kind of like an underground following now. But man, when it first came out, I'll never forget, it was my friend, Eladio, got a promo copy of it. I forgot, I don't know if he got it for free or whatever, but I remember vividly. It was a promo copy. And this is a guy that me and him grew up discovering, you know, Manowar, Cheap Trick, Kiss. You know, we were those childhood friends, you know. We knew each other in third grade. Still friends with him today, proud to say. And so he got this album and told me, dude, check out this Frank Marino album. It's really good. Man, he played me it and it floored me. This album is amazing. And I love Frank Marino, but this is maybe my favorite one. Actually, seriously, even better than Mahogany Rush Live. I know a lot of people won't agree with that, but man, this album smokes. It's called The Power of Rock and Roll. I remember it was a bitch for me to find. I did find it like a couple years later in a used bin, pristine condition, happy to say. And the album ends with a song that I think, in my personal opinion, it is the greatest guitar solos caught on any song in the history of songs. But then again, that's my opinion. Sure, it's not yours. So check out this song. This is Frank Marino singing a song about the critics that were saying rock and metal is dead. And this was his answer to them. This song is called Ain't Dead Yet.
Down, hold on.
Frank Marino eats frets for breakfast. That's Ain't Dead Yet off the album The Power of Rock and Roll. Get it. If you liked what you just heard, you need that album. Seriously. All right, so let's go into the comment section from the past episodes. From the last one where I did it alone. Music Matter says, does this K-Knock have any personality? Let your hair down, Robert. Oh, no, that's not for that episode. And that was rude. All right, Tom Tobin on that Vinnie Vincent episode, he says, I don't care about Vinnie's weight or his and her gender. I just wish he and she get it together. Well, I don't care about his weight either or the gender. I never did. You know, I may goof on it now because of what a scumbag he is and what he's done. But I can give a fuck. You know, I can give a fuck about Invasion, too. If he did something where he sang and didn't do 100 million shred fest things, then, yeah, sure, I'd like to hear it. But I wouldn't give that fucker a penny. I'd rather pay Zakk Wylde than that guy any day. Now I think about it, man. Zakk Wylde's a goddamn saint. Even his bodyguard's a goddamn saint compared to that fucking idiot. All right, this is Chris Merchant said, Vinnie Vincent Invasion sucked. The songs were just not good. Nothing but pointless noodling. Chris, I agree with you, though there are some songs on there that I could have seen be good songs. Like, I thought No Substitute was an okay song, but ruined by a variety of things. Phil Anderson, this is I don't know what episode this is from. He said, just wondering, how many times is fuck said in your song calling Dr. Fuck? It's go on Reverb Nation. It's a free download. Go to Reverb Nation, type in Dr. Fuck. You can download it for free and count it. And then get back to me and let me know how many times. Abby and Hannah's dad. Oh, he's a nice guy. Left a comment on my last one saying, always worth listening to. Awesome. Thank you, dude. You're always a good guy. Pewter's Baby said on the Vinnie Vincent, there's a lot of Vinnie Vincent things here. If I shake the magic eight ball, it says, you kill me, man. You're so cute having fun doing your thing. I'm now listening to Dr. Fuck, audio only, and liking it. My life has reached a new low, guilty pleasure-wise. Well, I don't know if I should take that as a compliment or an insult, but I'll take it either way. Thank you. I think. If not, then fuck you. Gazelle Diamond said, I don't know what these episodes are. He just says, great show. Thank you, Gazelle. And Mech, yeah, I'm reading off YouTube. It's hard to see the subject, the shows it is. In the end, you're doing the laugh at the end. Is it you doing the laugh at the end? Now I know what he's talking about. That's my last episode. I put up that recording I did with Necromaniac, Tables Are Turned. No, that is not my laugh at the end. I think that may be from a movie, that laugh. Sounds like it to me, because I don't know nobody that laughs like that. But I know what you're talking about. Okay, episode 23, whatever that is. Jersey Joe. I love Jersey Joe. Good guy. Dude, first of all, thanks for doing this shit, dude. When I get notifications that you're on, it's awesome. Roddy Piper, rest in peace. Your YouTube video titled Vinny Cancels Again, My Comment, got 83 likes. Wow. I just checked. Can't wait until the Metal Station Thursday. Yes, the Dr. Fuck Show on that Metal Station. This week, as I'm recording, this is July 1st. July 4th falls on Thursday, and unfortunately, I can't do my radio show this week because I'm going to be out there celebrating the birthday of the United States of America. So, next week, hopefully, Joe. And he continues, yes, you can yap because when you do your live feed, it's hard because you try to answer everyone's question, and I think that's cool. But here you can take your time and bullshit. Do you even think of setting up a separate phone number so people can call in like Eddie Trunk? I think that would be cool as fuck, bro. That would be awesome, Jersey, but I don't know how to do that. I really don't know, and anybody out there that knows, don't tell me because I'm really stupid at following orders. But if anybody out there that lives close to me, come on over and set me up. Because I would love to take phone calls. That'd be awesome. Acid Trip Massacre Band on the last episode. He says, Dave will kick cancer's ass. I'm with you, dude. I think he is as well. On the Vinny Vincent is washed up and has been that can't even play anymore. I don't give a rat's ass about him. I believe the rest is stuff I already read. Dr. E. Brown, he says, shout out to Dr. Fuck for doing this podcast and for calling out Vinny for his bullshit. Me, yourself, and the Classic Metal Show has touched on the action of this loser for a while. We all agree, Vinny is a greedy ripoff of an idiot and has very little regard for anyone but himself. Well said, Dr. Earl. And well said, everybody else. There's a lot of comments that mirror him. If you want to check it out, it's all on the YouTube thing. And I also want to thank Jersey Joe. And there was a couple on YouTube, Facebook that I don't have now. I have Michael Gleinmeier, who I call Nitro. He said, great episode. I refuse to buy the original art of Virgin Killer myself. I have the cheesy band photo cover, and I agree. House of the Holy is more artistic because, to me, Virgin Killer, the focus is on the little girl. I know, it's so... ugh. I really find that album disturbing. And believe me, you know, through the years, I've had people like, dude, check out what I got. And I'm like, oh, man. They get disappointed at my reaction. They think they're going to floor me with something super rare. Where I'm like, I don't give a fuck how rare that is. That shit is just too fucking... It's just not right. But I know there was another comment somebody other than Jersey Joe that said that he really enjoyed the episode of me just talking, you know, without a guest. So there'll be more of these. And hopefully they'll be with a guest that donates $40. Just $40 you donate. And you tell me, hey, look, I want to talk about this band. I want to talk about this movie. I want to talk about this subject. Anything that I am aware of, we'll talk about as long as you want. $40 and put it there and just say Vieira Vault. Now, remember, don't confuse the prices with Rock and Metal Combat Podcast with Vieira Vault. All right? Vieira Vault, I'm charging $40 to be on the show and you pick the subject where over at Rock and Metal Combat Podcast. It's $60 to guest and pick a subject. But, you know, if you just want to pick a subject, $40 over there. So, again, man, God, I love you. You still fucking listening. That's fucking awesome. Well, till hopefully next week, I'm going to do my best. I'll come up with another subject matter or something. Or, even better, I have one of you cool fuckers that donated $40 to be on the Vieira Vault. Till next time, my friends, smack 'em a gob. This has been brought to you by MiamiMetalMerchant.com for your metal needs at competitive prices. Visit MiamiMetalMerchant.com. Tell them Dr. Fuck sent you.
I am Dr. Fuck.
And I'm the Total Alcoholic.
And we are part of the Rock and Metal Combat Podcast.
We are the Rock and Metal Combat Podcast.
That's right. And the way you can check us out is we are on iTunes and also Podbean. And we've got a review recently. I got this review right here. It says right here, it says, Rock and Metal Combat Podcast is the greatest podcast in the world. And it's my number one podcast. Signed by Science. Now, and then Science also said...
Science
also said... My second favorite podcast is It Doesn't Matter, The Rest Suck. Rock and Metal Combat Podcast on iTunes and Podbean. Check it out.
Science!